Hey, welcome back, everyone. It is now November 7th of 2021, and ever since the very end of The Mandalorian Season 2 and The Bad Batch, a lot of fans have really been looking forward to shows like Kenobi and Ahsoka, as well as other ones out there that are yet to be announced by Disney that will be fully unveiled at Star Wars Celebration, one of which being revealed on Disney Plus Day on November 12th, so keep your eyes open next week for that. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars updates. Also, by the way, guys, I am on Twitter if you guys want to go ahead and give me a follow on there, at Mike01. I do post a couple of fun and entertaining things on there from time to time and interact with you guys further. So, the thing about the future of Star Wars right now is that they have a lot on their plate. We're talking about Disney, of course, right? They have a lot on their plate right now when it comes to TV shows, movies, all of these different projects that are currently being announced that are really gonna all interconnect with each other. You know, we have the books, the novels, and the comics that are going to be unveiled and teased at Celebration that's gonna tie directly into either the movies or the TV shows or whatever it may be that will be announced also at Celebration. So also keep note that during Celebration, they're going to have a lot of others on stage, like George Lucas, Hayden, Ewan McGregor, all the like, that's really going to have a lot to do with these new announcements, not just for the Kenobi series, but also for new Star Wars shows down the line. So, with that being said, of course, what's really all the more intriguing about all of this is exactly what Chapek has planned for the future of the franchise and the structure of the brand, right? Now, we do know that Chapek so far is doing an excellent job. I mean, after all, he is allowing Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni to do as they please with these new Star Wars projects. You know, given that Dave Filoni and Jon Favreau, they know a lot about Star Wars legends and the deep lore of the franchise, they are trying to bring that back to life. So, with that being said, given that Star Wars will be going through multiple major announcements during Star Wars Celebration, Bob Chapek is currently putting together a very in-depth format of how the event will be handled with tons of new Star Wars announcements coming to the Star Wars fandom. However, it's described that Disney already has plans for a new Lucasfilm president to step in and take control of the Star Wars universe in order to replace Kathleen Kennedy. Now, it's described that so far, Bob Chapek has been very unhappy with Kathleen Kennedy's work on the Acolyte TV series, given that it is now costing Disney even more money, since production has been further delayed and that now the higher-ups over at Disney are in the final stages of replacing Kathleen Kennedy by the beginning of 2023. Now, the reason as to why they are waiting until 23 is that by contract, Kathleen Kennedy holds creative control over the Acolyte series and over the marketing of the show, as well as business portions of the entire Star Wars franchise by Disney. However, Disney's plan right now is to have creator George Lucas to take over as the new president of Lucasfilm temporarily by the third quarter of 2022 next year, before they make a final decision on the permanent replacement, which now there are actually three different candidates, one of which being Jon Favreau. Now, it is likely that the other two candidates are Dave Filoni and the mystery slot that we have yet to learn. However, this is heavily in the works and that Disney wants to create a new face for Lucasfilm and the entire Star Wars brand in order to not only regain the trust of the fans, but also create new, dedicated fans for the Star Wars universe. Now, 2023 is best described to be a transformative year of Disney, Star Wars as a whole, and that 2022 will be the first step in that direction to its completion. Chapek is making the necessary steps to not only do things right with Star Wars creatively speaking, but also financially, in order to actually make Star Wars a secure franchise for Disney. Now, the announcement of plans for a new Lucasfilm president is set to be teased sometime during the summer of next year, in which they are aiming to hold a special earnings call for this choice that they are currently making right now that will go into full effect in the third quarter of 22, where Lucas will be labeled as Lucasfilm president, even while Kathleen Kennedy is still attached to the company before her departure in 2023. Now, very similar to how when Chapek took over Disney as CEO, while Iger was still considered technically the CEO at the time, Disney is said to be doing just that with George Lucas and Kathleen Kennedy by the third quarter of next year. However, the permanent choice won't be unveiled until late next year, around December or so, and that Favreau has been in the talks with Chapek about this, and it's an ongoing discussion that has been going on for weeks already. Now, Favreau and Filoni have shown interest. It's all a matter of whether or not they're really going to have the time to do something like that with all of these new TV shows on their plate. Now, here's the thing about this, all right? We do know that Kathleen Kennedy is no longer creatively involved with any other Star Wars project except the Acolyte TV series, all right? In fact, they had an agreement about 2 months ago that if the Acolyte TV series meets expectations and if it really does agree with fans, which I'm not quite sure if it will, you know, I can't judge it just yet without seeing any shred of footage, but I will say that I really don't have my hopes up, is what I'm saying, for that show because of who's attached to it. If it all goes well, Disney is actually agreeing to greenlight a season 2 for the Acolyte TV show. In fact, they've been talking about prematurely even doing that before in the past. Now, I think that obviously filling in Lucas as the temporary quote-unquote president of Lucasfilm is a very interesting business move and a very interesting marketing move to really kind of regain the fans' interest in Lucasfilm as a company. Now, like I say, they're trying to aim for that exact kind of format of what they did with Disney. When Chapek took over, Iger was still in there as CEO. So technically you had two CEOs, but really Chapek was running the program, if that makes sense. They're doing the same exact thing in, you know, the third quarter of 22 between Lucas and Kathleen Kennedy. And it's going to be a very interesting call to make by Chapek and a very intriguing move. It's going to be very, very, you know, interesting to see what the fans are going to think about this and whether or not some fans out there might be very upset that it's only going to be a temporary fill-in before they make that permanent solution, right? Whether it be Favreau, Filoni, or that mystery slot that's currently up in the air. To be honest, I'm not quite sure if we're going to be able to see Filoni and or Favreau fill in. We'll have to wait and see. It's all a matter of how heavily invested they're going to be with all of these new Star Wars projects moving forward, right? They're not going to be writing all of them. Keep that in mind. They're not going to be writing every single Star Wars TV show that's coming out. They are going to be getting other creators where John and Dave will be used as people that will supervise those projects and kind of call the shots here and there on the creative aspects. So that's good news as well. Even if they're not writing something, they're still going to be somewhat in control. And that leaves them up with a lot of free time to take on the business portion. They could absolutely do it. It's just a matter of whether or not they're going to have the free time to do that. So, like I said before in the past, I think that obviously when we go ahead and examine everything that Kathleen Kennedy has done, you can see that she has caused nothing but a chain reaction of car crashes, of these failures at the box office with Solo: A Star Wars Story, or fans not getting their expectations out of the sequel trilogy movies, and Rian Johnson getting hired for The Last Jedi, and him getting a new trilogy that is, to be quite honest with you, left a complete secret that it was actually canceled. Things have been a mess by Kathleen Kennedy, there's no denying that. And obviously this is the right direction, the right call to make, and I cannot wait to see what Star Wars is going to be like 3 years from now, and then just looking back at the entire community, looking back at Disney as a company and how Lucasfilm operates, and just seeing the contrast of all of them, what that's going to look like. So anyways, guys, you know, drop a comment below. Let me know about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you also very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time. Night to moon, we hear them moans again, no.